Dear students, I am Soumya Chandrika, Department of Commerce, AIH National College, Gauripidnur. Today I am going to discuss about, for the 6M BCom students, the topic is appointment of auditor. How the auditor should be appointed in a company. According to Section 139 of Companies Act 2013, this section will be providing how the auditor should be appointed in any company, whether it is a government or private. So there will be so many ways to appointing an auditor. In that, the ways are appointment of first auditor, appointment of subsequent auditor, and appointment in the case of casual vacancies, and appointment by special resolution, and appointment in through annual reappointment. So in that, first we have to discuss about appointment of first auditor. How the first auditor should be appointed in any company. Regarding that, if the company is incorporated for the first time or to start a business, each and every company should appoint an auditor, because the Companies Act will be prescribing the company to appoint an auditor. So regarding that appointment of first auditor, In the case of government company, the auditor is appointed by Controller and Audit General of India, and the two within 60 days of registration, that is incorporation of business. And if the Controller and Audit General of India fails to appoint an auditor within 60 days, in that case, the Board of Directors will appoint in next 30 days. If the Board of Directors fails to appoint, in that case, the members of the company will appoint in next 60 days at an extraordinary general meeting, who shall hold the office till the conclusion of first annual general meeting. And in the case of other than government company, that is in the case of private companies, in the private companies, the appointment of auditor by Board of Directors within 30 days of registration or 30 days of incorporation of a company. If in most of the cases, all the joint stock companies, the Board of Directors only appointing an auditor. If the Board of Directors fails to appoint, in that case, the members of the company, that is the shareholders, the members of the company will appoint an auditor within 90 days in the annual general meeting. Whoever the person should be appointed through the annual general meeting, that person should be considered as a auditor if the Board of Directors and the members of the company also fails to appoint an auditor. In that case, that too within 90 days, in that case, the central government will appoint an auditor. And the tenure of the auditor should be for the conclusion of first annual general meeting only. That is regarding of appointment of first auditor. And whoever the auditor will be appointed for the next time, second year, third year, like that. So that auditor, we can call it as a subsequent auditor. The appointment of subsequent auditor, in that case, in the case of government companies, the appointment of auditor will be done by the Controller and Audit General of India within 190 days from the commencement of financial year, and who shall hold the office till the conclusion of annual general meeting. In the case of other than government companies, the auditor is appointed by members of the company in the first annual general meeting, and who shall hold the office from the conclusion of that annual general meeting till the conclusion of its sixth annual general meeting, and thereafter till the conclusion of every sixth general meeting, the auditor should be appointed. The tenure of the auditor in the case of government company, till the conclusion of annual general meeting, first annual general meeting. And in the case of a companies, the tenure is till the conclusion of sixth annual general meeting. That is for the 5 years. Whoever the person should be appointed as an auditor in any company, he shall hold the office up to 5 years. That is the second case. And in the third case, appointment in the case of a casual vacancies. So generally, the casual vacancies, the vacancies will be done by like arising, like death or resignation or insolvency, or so many reasons. So many reasons, if the auditor place is vacant, that place should be filled by any one person, authorized person of a company. So regarding that, in the case of casual vacancy, it should be filled in the case of a government companies by controller and annual audit general of India in 30 days. Within 30 days, they have to be appointed. In the case of failure by the C&AG, board of directors will fill in that next 30 days. And in the case of private companies, if because of casual vacancy is that is arising due to other reasons like death, insolvency, in that case, the board of directors should be appointing or filling that casual vacant place within 30 days. If the vacant place is arising due to the resignation, in that case, the resigned place, that place should be filled by the board of directors within 30 days, but the same should be approved by the members in the general meeting. If the board of directors can get the approval from the general meeting through the members, it should be within 3 months of the recommendations of the board only, the board of directors will appointing a auditor. That is in the case of a casual vacancies. So generally, the auditor will be having a there is no rule to resign. So this is in the case of a appointment of a casual vacancies. And other case is appointment by special resolution. So here the auditor should be appointed by special resolutions. That is a Companies Amendment Act 1974. That's in the section 224A, which will be providing in the case of a company in which 25% or more of the subscriber share capital is held, whether it is individually or collectively by any public financial institution or any government company or any state government, they can appointing an auditor by special resolution. That is the first case. Another one, if the same company will be a tie up with that any financial or other institution established by any provincial or state act in which the state government holds not less than 51% of the subscriber share capital, in that financial institution or any other institution shall be appointing an auditor by special resolution, or any nationalized bank or an insurance company which will be carrying only a general insurance business, the appointment of an auditor shall be made by a special resolution. Whenever the auditor should be appointed by a special resolution, if the company definitely in the general meeting, whenever the resolution passed, that will be passed only, the person should be appointed. If the company fails to pass a resolution, special resolution, it shall be deemed that no auditor has been appointed by the company at its annual general meeting. So here the chance will be taken, the power will be taken by a central government to appointing an auditor. That is in the case of a appointment of an auditor by special resolution. And another case is annual reappointment of an auditor. So here, after completing of a tenure of 5 years, the auditor may be reappointed. After completing of 5 years, the auditor may be reappointed at annual general meeting. We can say it as a retiring auditor. The retiring auditor may be reappointed at annual general meeting. According to section 139 of subsection 9, it should be states that the subject to the provisions of subsection 1 and the rules made thereunder, a retiring auditor may be reappointed at annual general meeting. If he is not disqualified for reappointment or he has not given the company a notice in writing of his unwillingness to be reappointed, or a special resolution has not been passed at that meeting appointing some other auditor or providing expressly that he shall not be appointed, in that case, the retiring auditor should be reappointed at annual general meeting. Where at an annual general meeting, no auditor is appointed or reappointed, the existing auditor, whoever will be working presently, the same existing auditor shall continue to be the auditor of the company. So like this way, the auditor should be appointed in any organization, any company. That is in the case of first auditor and appointment of an auditor by special resolution and appointment of an auditor by casual vacancies and appointment through annual general meeting and reappointment of an auditor. This is the topic we are covered today, appointment of an auditor. Thank you.